Now, there's just one last thing we need to take care of in our data model: deletion rules. What are deletion rules? Well, let me ask you this. What happens to all the notes in a notebook when this notebook is deleted? And what happens to the notebook when a note inside it is deleted? These questions can be resolved setting deletion rules. Let's start with the notes property. The deletion rules are over here, and we have several options. No action, which is usually not something that you want to use. Nullify, cascade, and deny. Denied is also something that you usually don't use. So our common options are nullified and cascade. When we delete a notebook, what should we do to the notes? They should be deleted also. That's what cascade means. When notebook is deleted, all the linked notes will go away. So they should be cascade. And we need to do the same thing for the inverse relationship. What happens to the notebook when one note is deleted? Should we delete the notebook? Obviously not. What we should do is remove the reference that that notebook had to this note. That is what nullify does. One last warning before we move on. Getting your deletion rules wrong is one of the most common beginner mistakes. If you set cascade on both relationships, your app will crash. We'll talk about that later. So pause this video now and set up your deletion rules now as well. And that's it. We're done setting up the model. And from now on, it's going to be pretty smooth sailing.